And we all know when money is tight, people have to cut back on spending. And that also goes for the state of California. Right now, lawmakers and the governor are trying to figure out what to cut. So our Jeannie Nguyen shows us why some Californians are hoping that funding for homeless crisis is not on the chopping block.
I know what it is to be hungry. I know what it is to sleep on the streets.
On the steps of the Capitol Tuesday morning, dozens of people gathered to demand an end to homelessness.
Solutions to homelessness are not something that we can fund only when we have a surplus or only when we feel like it.
A group of advocates and lawmakers called on the legislature to continue to work on finding and funding a solution to end the crisis, with the legislative analyst's office estimating the state deficit at $58 billion this year. This group believes making additional cuts is not an option.
If the legislature is going to cut $1.2 billion, what are you saying to the people that voted you in?
This comes after voters passed Proposition 1, which allows the state to borrow nearly $6.4 billion in bonds, with $2 billion of that meant to create housing. The rest will pay for new facilities for mental health and addiction treatment. Specifics on the rest of the spending will be decided later.
Reversing the cycle of homelessness in California through ongoing funding at scale, not at the bottom.
During Tuesday's snow survey with the Department of Water Resources, Governor Gavin Newsom addressed Proposition 1 and the state's budget.
We'll have a lot to say on that and the budget as we get closer to the state of the state.
But when will the state of the state happen, and what will be cut from the budget? Governor Newsom didn't have much to say.
It's their house, their rules, and I'll abide by them.
All right, and Jeannie's with us right now. Obviously, those advocates wanted their voices to be heard, but assembly members were also there too. What did they have to say about all this?
Alex, there were assembly members there today from major cities, and they actually sided with the advocates and those experiencing homelessness. Now, assembly member Chris Ward did say today that there needs to be a balance in funding shelters and housing, and of course, he will work to make that happen.
All right, Jeannie, thank you so much for the update. And you know, we will continue to follow this.